Hi everyone. So my theme is health effects of meditation. A growing number of people are seeking health recovery treatment with a holistic approach to the human being. Meditation is a mental training capable of producing connection between the mind, body, and spirit. Its practice helps people to achieve balance, relaxation, and self-control, in addition to the development of consciousness. At present, meditation is classified as a complementary and integrative technique in the area of health. There is no group difference in total cortical thickness, but higher gray matter volumes in right subcortical areas in the meditation group. Gray matter volume decreased with age with all subjects, though the decrease was less in the meditating subjects. At age 50, brains of meditators were estimated to be 7.5 years younger than those of controls. It was found thicker cortices in brain areas supporting a wide range of cognitive processes, including matter awareness, body awareness, memory consolidation and reconsolidation, self and emotional regulation, and intra and inter-hemispheric communications. Some meditations involve deep concentration, others prescribe attention to external and internal stimuli, and others are inwardly directed towards non-dual states. Thus, brain patterns from different practices would not be expected to converge to a common pattern. Looking at brain areas reported active during meditation practices in the above table, we find all brain areas except of primary sensory cortices were reported to be activated by meditation practices. Buddhist meditation were characterized by bilateral activation in the frontal superior medial gyrus, activation in the right parietal supramarginal gyrus, which is associated with language processing, and the supplementary motor area. Indian meditation were associated with left lateralized activation of the postcentral gyrus, the superior parietal lobe, and the hippocampus, the left superior temporal gyrus, and the right middle cingulate cortex. So, Buddhist meditation in this study enhanced brain areas associated with language processing and motor areas. Indian meditation in this study enhanced brain areas associated with sensory processing, language processing, attention, and memory areas. During focused attention meditation, activation were observed in two brain areas associated with voluntary regulation of thought and action, the premotor cortex and the dorsal anterior cingulate cortex. During mantra recitation meditation, areas of activation included the posterior dorsolateral prefrontal cortex, motor cortex, and putamen pallidus. During open monitoring meditation, significant clusters of activation were observed, the insula, left inferior frontal, and motor cortices. During loving kindness meditation, higher brain activation as observed in the right anterior insula and anterior inferior parietal lobule. These four categories of meditation differ on the level of description of their procedures and on the level of brain activation patterns. This supports the value of assigning meditation to meaningful categories before combining neuronal imaging data. Focused attention meditation entails voluntary focusing attention on a chosen object in a sustained fashion. Voluntary focused attention is associated with gamma activity. Gamma is seen in any tasks that involve effortful thinking and control of the mind. Gamma EEG is driven by local processing within short-range connection responsible for perceptual awareness, selective attention, neuronal processing, and communication between regions. Open monitoring meditation involves a non-reactive monitoring of the content of experience from moment to moment primarily as a means to recognize the nature of emotional and cognitive patterns. Non-reactive monitoring is associated with midline frontal theta. Theta is produced whenever one attends to internal mental processing. Frontal midline theta is a marker of working memory tasks and episodic memory encoding and retrieval processes. Scientists compared EEG correlates of novice mindfulness subjects whose mind wandered frequently during the practice to EEG from experienced mindfulness subjects whose minds wandered less. They found higher midline data EEG at somatosensory alpha in the experienced subjects. A recent meta-analysis of EEG patterns also reported that alpha was found in posterior, parietal, and central areas during open mantic practices. A third category, automatic self-transcending, is for meditations that transcend the step of practices. Frontal alpha EEG is predicted to characterize meditation with these procedures. Alpha oscillations have been found to play an active role in the suppression of task irrelevant processing, being negative correlated with local cortical excitability. Frontal alpha could indicate the frontal executive processing is being inhibited. It was used these EEG frequency bands to assign meditation to categories. Meditations that were characterized by gamma EEG were placed in the focused attention category. The essence of mind technique, a Tibetan Buddhist technique aimed at experiencing a brilliantly awake, limitless, and non-dual state of awareness, is also characterized by higher gamma and beta 2 EEG and would be placed in this category. So, what's the effect of meditation on the body and why meditation is a healthy habit? Meditation reduces stress. Many styles of meditation can help reduce stress. Meditation can likewise reduce symptoms in people with stress-triggered medical conditions. Habitual meditation can help reduce anxiety and improve stress reactivity and coping skills. Mindfulness meditation helps reduce anxiety symptoms in people with generalized anxiety disorder, along with increasing positive self-statements and improving stress reactivity and coping. People are receiving meditation. People who receive meditation therapies experience reduced symptoms of depression compared with those in a control group. Some forms of meditation can improve depression and reduce negative thoughts. It may also decrease levels of inflammatory cytokines, which could contribute to depression. Self-inquiry and related styles of meditation can help you know yourself. This can be a starting point of making other positive changes. Focus attention meditation is like weight lifting for your attention span. It helps increase the strain and endurance of your attention. For example, one study found that people who listen to a meditation tape experience improved attention and accuracy while completing a task, compared with those in a control group. Several types of meditation may build your ability to redirect and maintain attention. The improved focus you can gain through regular meditation may boost you, your memory and mental clarity. These benefits can help fight age-related memory loss and dementia. Metta or loving-kindness meditation is a practice of developing positive feeling first towards yourself and then towards others. Metta increases positivity, empathy, and compassionate behavior towards others. Meditation develops mental awareness and can help you manage triggers for unwanted impulses. This can help you recover from addiction, manage unhealthy eating, and redirect other unwanted habits. One study compared mindfulness-based meditation programs and found that people who meditated stayed asleep longer and had improved insomnia severity compared with those who had an unmedicated control condition. A variety of meditation techniques can help you relax and control runaways thoughts that can interfere with sleep. This can shorten the time it takes to fall asleep and increase sleep quality. Thank you for your attention.